So we're back here at Devoxx, and I'm here with Sam Dutton to talk about disruptive media. That's what your session was
absolutely
called. So, so you think that you're working on standards, and you believe standards can actually help to create, stimulate content creation, and by content creation we mean, you know, maybe even artists, and we can bring to the web something that was not there today. So tell me what.
Yeah, no, sure. Well, we're really looking forward to seeing what, you know, people make of WebRTC. I mean, at this point, you know, it's been kind of in the hands of people who do telephony and video conferencing and so on. But I think what's really exciting is what web developers are going to make, because they're going to do a whole stack of creative stuff with that now. It's fantastic.
So WebRTC is just one of the technologies, and we'll talk about that. Is that part of a bigger picture, or is that the one and only thing you need?
Yeah, so WebRTC has several components. So, you know, it needs some. You need some way to get streaming media to work with WebRTC. So that has the media stream API. People have done some stuff already, some great demos using Get User Media with that. And then the kind of meat of the project is this thing called Rtc Peer Connection, which is the bit that deals with streaming data between two peers.
Right, and peers are browsers.
Yeah, and a
no
peer is a browser.
Server involved in there.
Yeah, no, that's right. So just to kind of rewind a bit, you know, what we've had is with the internet is the, you know, with the web we've had this kind of, I don't know, kind of kickstarting the information age. We've had this ability to kind of share information, to create stuff and distribute it, and then to discover stuff and to actually consume content, and you know, services and media and so on. Now, that's great, but it's there's been this kind of missing piece, which is the business of kind of person to person, like person to person communication. This is kind of one of the last, I don't know, really major challenges for the web, and this is what we need with real time communication, and that's what WebRTC is bringing to us.
So, and this is what used to cost a lot, and with, I mean, systems.
Yeah.
Can do that. We technically do that today.
Absolutely, yeah, sure.
But the web can make that accessible to, you know, take it to the next level.
Like So what we've had in the past is kind of corporate closed systems that have, some have worked better than others, but they've always been expensive to implement and difficult to integrate. And of course, there's never been a way to directly integrate stuff with your web apps. What we have now is the use of plugins like Flash, which you know, work well in many ways, but are problematic, but are essentially closed and are separate. And also thinking about security, you know, they're not part of the sandbox browser environment. Right. So WebRTC has also been built with security in mind, using secure protocols. And because it's within the browser, continually updated, sandboxed, it's inherently more secure.
So what do you send? What kind of data can you share?
Yeah.
I mean, I mean, developers care about that.
It's, it's exciting to think what people are going to do with it. So with WebRTC, the kind of core of it is this idea of voice and video calling.
Right.
That kind of makes sense. So a lot of the optimizations have been about working with voice to essentially do what you can do with telephony. But we've also got this ability to do really high quality video chat. We're already seeing very good quality, very you know, low latency video chat,
right,
which is fantastic. The third kind of part of the WebRTC picture, in a way, is an API called Data Channel. Now, what that enables you to do is arbitrary streaming data between browsers. So that's like anything. So you could be streaming any kind of arbitrary data, not just audio, video data, anything. So a stack of really, I mean, who knows?
Oh, who knows? I can imagine quite a few things already.
Yeah.
So maybe for developers, what does RDC mean? I mean, where do they get
started?
And why is it even a good thing in the first place? I mean, they like Flash today, and maybe that,
so
at least for the player, that offers
absolutely
some solution.
So, I mean, you know, we've talked to Flash developers who've, you know, who've kind of had some struggles, really, and you know, are really pleased to hear about the project, in particular because it's, you know, WebRTC provides, they're just APIs within the browser, so they're really easy to integrate with your existing workflow and your existing web apps.
It is web development.
Yeah,
right?
It's web development. It's
API,
not like you've
got
to bring in the Flash guy or the whatever. You know, you've got people who work on the web, who use the web, who use the APIs. So that's the first part. The second big deal is that there's no licensing. You know, Google has done a huge amount of work on their stuff and made it then open sourced, freely available. So there's no licensing for the developers or for the end users. So, you know, it's good for everyone.
Okay, great. So where should people go to get started if they're interested? And what does the next 6 months or 12 months or 2 years look like?
Yep. So the place to start with WebRTC is webrtc.org. It's the kind of natural home for WebRTC. There's articles on HTML5 rocks. There's a book called WebRTC Book. Really nice, book for the Kindle. It's about, £6 something. It's cheap, about €8, I think.
Yep.
There's some great video too. Check out Justin Uberti's Google I.O. video. Really good place to start. And there's lots of resources online to
Right. What does the roadmap for WebRTC look like?
Yeah, so the next 6 months, there's a lot of work on, keeping going with standardization projects. We want to integrate Mozilla work. The WebRTC has just been implemented in Firefox Nightlies and Aurora.
Okay.
And we want to integrate the work there with the work that's been implemented in Chrome. Obviously, there's a big push now for mobile. That's, the kind of natural home for personal Absolutely. Communication. And, and then, of course, data channel to see an implementation. It is in Firefox, but we want to see that in Chrome soon.
Okay, wonderful. So lots of things to look at.
Yeah, thanks. Indeed.
Thanks, Sam.
Yeah, cheers, Alexei. Good to talk.